I hope he dies. No, seriously, his character is annoying. Yeah? I know this is a comedy show. He could die in an accident, you know. Or an illness. The possibilities are endless. Just gotta be creative about it. You done? Here, let me get that for you. No, sit down. It's just fair, you know. I cook and do the dishes, and then I'm rewarded with the sight of you all cute and comfy on the couch. Now, sit down and let me do the rest. Hey, babe, do you want some ice cream for dessert? There's a half a tub left of the strawberry cheesecake from last time. Yeah, okay. Here you go. One spoon for you and one for me. Now, where were we? Fine, he wasn't that bad. Kind of bland, especially for a comedy movie, but not that bad. Aw, sleepy already? Come here. I swear, you have the most kissable forehead. Yeah, I'm perfectly fine. Why wouldn't I be? Of course I look tired. Because I am. I got off of work 3 hours ago, remember? No, I'm not making myself work even at home, too. I don't consider showing my partner how much I love them work. Plus, cooking's always been my way to decompress. Yeah, my actual work's been stressful lately. No thanks to my boss. I'm fine, seriously. I just need a bit of rest. What do you mean this whole week? It's really nothing. I'm not... It's just work getting the best of me. This honestly feels like I'm being interrogated. What are you gonna do next? Cuff me up? Maybe on the bedpost? Kinky. No, I'm not trying to change the subject. You can ask me more questions right after you cuff me in bed, officer. Okay, I'll be serious this time. I swear, nothing's wrong. It's just my thoughts getting the best of me, like usual. This doesn't seem like the usual. You know that fear you get when shit's going too good? Yeah, like I reached my peak. And you know how peaks go. It's all downhill from here. Well, yeah, maybe I am wrong. But it just kind of feels like it is. You really can't read me that easily, huh? I've been trying not to feel it, but I swear I took up more chores because I do like doing things for you, not just to avoid it. You holding my face like this feels nice. Huh? Where are you going? What? Babe, what are you doing to the coffee table? Hey, let me help you with that. Babe, you know I go along with your dumb shenanigans, but what the hell are we doing? You know what? Fine. You want to move the couch too? Then we move the couch. Okay. Couch moved. What now? We dance? Wait, so we moved the furniture just so we could have room to dance? Ah. Whoa. Pulling me over. Okay, they're dominant. Oh, you're more of a power bottom than anything. Hey! Don't hit me. I'm only telling the truth. What song am I feeling like dancing to? How about you pick? You are? Oh, you're making a playlist. Then I guess you can add My Girl. So, let's dance? I just can't make people stay. I think everyone has different shaped holes in their hearts, and I try to mold myself to fit them. And I can't help but hope for some semblance of love back, you know? Ow, my toe. No, it's fine. Don't worry. I care for people the way I think they deserve. And an expectation forms in the back of my head no matter how many times I tell myself real love asks for nothing in return. And then I feel like a fraud because sometimes it seems like I'm giving them attention just so I can get it back, not because I actually care. But I do. I do care. I do, right? It doesn't matter anyways. I never fit the mold perfectly, because there's still me in there. It's like I'm doing somersaults to compensate for being me, and life sticking its tongue out at me like a wrecked bitch. Yes, you're allowed to laugh. That's the whole point, babe. It's scary how I can just let go and let you know these things. I guess your insistence helps. Yeah, and when you help organize my clothes, too. It's a barter system, you know? You help me get my shit together, and in return I tell you things I don't tell most people. Ah, fuck. Shit, babe. I'm gonna need a tally on how many toes I'm losing. You know, I can see myself living like this, with you, for the rest of my life. I love you. It's why I'm so scared. I know it's irrational, but what if we get into this huge fight and you realize I'm not worth keeping around? And then what if my idiot ass, like my other friendships and relationships, push you away completely because I'm too scared to deal with it? Either I fuck up like that, or things end with, you did nothing wrong, this just doesn't feel right anymore. What the hell did I do to make them feel like it isn't, right? I know I'm not responsible for that kind of feeling, but it's hard to think that way when shit repeats itself. It's a fucking pattern, and I can't stop it, and fuck, I don't know. I know people change. People grow apart. That's life. But was it at least real? The connection I felt? And why did it all fall apart? Now I'm just like, they'll be gone in a year when I vibe with someone. It's fucking pathetic. Yeah, I remember that. You were breaking down, hyperventilating and shit. I remember how you were questioning all the choices you made up until that point, and yeah? What about it? Of course I stuck around. You were a mess, and it hurt seeing you like that. I couldn't just leave you alone. I'm the worst at comforting people, though. I'm surprised you wanted me around. Yeah, it was pretty bad. You really felt like you hit rock bottom? Well, yeah. If we got through you being at the worst point of your life and whatever crisis I'm having now, we're pretty much unstoppable, huh? I'd like to try out this forever thing with you. You promise you'll stay? A promise of my own, too? Hit me. If it's low yield, then I should change my method? That... yeah. That makes sense. I'll keep that in mind. No more molding myself to fit, whatever the fuck I said minutes ago. That's how much metaphor my brain cells are capable of. Ow, goddamn. Babe, I love dancing with you, but your learning curve is really curved.